Good evening. So in last video we have seen that is design of top chord members and design of bottom chord members. Now in this we are going to be design of struts and slings, or we can say that is internal member in the trusses. So we have now this members, which members we have to go actually. So you can see this, we have these members, that is member BC, then we have member BC, then we have DE, CD, then we have EF. So we are going to consider all these members and we are going to make the group. And then from that we will decide. Now this member we have 4-0. So this we can go for single angle, and this is actually purpose of this is to reduce this length. Otherwise this length will be 3.2 meter. And for this one, your design of IK, instead of IK it becomes IM, and your compressive stress, that is allowable compressive stress, will be very less. And therefore we are going to provide this for stability purpose, and again to reduce this length of the member. So now we have, first we can say BC, and BC we have 12.58, 6.17. Then we have CD, that is 22.13, 11.24. Now if you will see, tensile forces are very less, 3.02 and 19.26, 19.80. EF we have 26.99, 13.28. FG we have 25.16, 18.43. GH we have 30.45, 16.13. HI we have, that is 29.46, 16.71. And IJ we have, that is 33.20 and 19.02. Now you may be thinking of that we have hair force, that is 30.45. And air force we have 33.20, then why we are designing these two? Because if you will see member GH, then we have this member GH, and length of member, that is IJ, if you will calculate, this length of member IJ is much greater than your length of this member GH. Because here we have root of these values, and therefore we have to make these two separate, because force in this member, that is allowable compressive stress, is less than this, and single angle 50-56 is not going to satisfy value of this IJ, and therefore I made it as separate. Now I am not going to design any slings over here, because tensile force, if you will see that value of tensile force we have, that is very less, highest 29.46 kilonewton. And for single angle, we have that value, that is larger one, that we will see when we will design this 30.45 kilonewton. So now we have to design for 30.45 kilonewton and check for 16.13. And then we will again go for single angle section for these all members, except we already mentioned this, that is for IJ. There we have to go double. Why we have to go double, that we can see. So now we are going to consider, that is single angle 50-56, and for single angle we know that minimum, R minimum is always RVB. So now we will have this clause number 7.5.1.2, and we are considering two bolts and with a fixed connection. This we have already seen, we have solved problems on this, we have calculated lambda VB, and value of L you can see we have, that is 2828. So this value we have calculated, and how we have calculated this value for the member GH. So we have this member as GH, so we are interested to find this value. Then we have this as 1.6, and this value we have calculated, and we by using this total distance we have, so 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 4.8 meters. And then vertical we have to calculate, we have this angle as 19.93, and we have calculated this value, and then by using this 1.6 and this vertical we are going to get this value of the length, and I got this as 2828 millimeters. And from this we have this L upon RVB, and then from this we will get lambda VB 2.82, lambda 5 0.094, Kelvin we have 0.2, 0.35, 20, and lambda E 1.78. Then 5, we have calculated 2.48 FCD 54.02 section again semi-compact, so A equal to A, and PD we will get 30.69 kilonewton. Then you can see 33, we have larger one, and therefore this angle is not satisfied, and therefore I have a double angle section for that member IJ. And then we have this value greater than 30.49 kilonewton, 45 kilonewton. We have to check it for tensile strength. And again, now here we have considered only two bolts. If you will see force, which is very less, 16 around. And then we have single, bearing. We have single shear. Then also our value is more than that one. So minimum we are going to provide two bolts for it. That we have already mentioned above, and therefore we have taken two bolts at each end, and from this we have calculated tensile strength, which will be TDG. Then we have 129.09 because it is independent of your connection. Then we have TDN. Now TDN, you can see we have value of beta. This beta we have, that is 0.02, greater than 0.7. Then we have TDN 104.60 kilonewton. And then block shear strength we have calculated, and that block shear strength we got value that is equal to 91.02 kilonewton. And then minimum of this we have 91.02 kilonewton, greater than 16.13 kilonewton, therefore safe. And then we have to go for second, which is 33.20 kilonewton. Length of the member is 3312 millimeter. How we have to calculate that, already I have shown you for other member, and same way you can calculate this. And then we have FCD assumed 35, and then area of angle required 474.29, but this will not satisfy our requirement, that is single angle we have 474, and we will take it as 50-56. So for only two members, if we will go other angle section, then that will not be your economical one, and therefore we have to provide same cross section throughout, and then we have taken that is 50-56. We have ZZ axis, YY axis, and then from this same way we have calculated this. We have two bolts already we have mentioned, and therefore we have taken two bolts over there, and then we have 53.97 FCD. We are getting it as 31.93, and then from this semi-compact angle section we will get PD 36.27 kilonewton. Just see it, and which is greater than 33.20 kilonewton, and therefore we have to go for double angle section. So I have made these two groups, that this member we have only one group, and other members we can have the in single angle 50-56, and we have to check it, and we know this value that is going to be again greater one. So we have got it as 91, and 2 into 91 it will be larger one, and therefore I have not designed any tensile member, or I can say slings over here. So we have 91.02 kilonewton, greater than 19.02 kilonewton, therefore safe. So likewise, you have to go for these other members which are not involved in your top chord member and bottom chord member. Thank you.